Speaking to one and all present here,
I, Gwennon D'Souza of fourth year,
Satyam Kumar of third year,
Ashwin Raj of third year,
welcome you all to the grand celebration of the 30th Foundation Day of Rajiv Gandhi Institute of Veterinary Education and Research, Puducherry.
அனைவருக்கும் மாலை வணக்கம். எமது கல்லூரியின் 30வது நிறுவன நாள் விழாவுக்கு வருகை தந்திருக்கும் அனைவரையும் வருக வருக என வரவேற்கிறோம்.
As we celebrate the pearl jubilee of our college, we are honored to have our chief guest for the evening, Dr. V. Serian, Dean and Patron of Student Council River. We are also delighted to welcome our guest of honor for the evening, Joint Director, FSSAI Tamil Nadu and Puducherry, Dr. K. A. Arul Anand. Dr. Anand is our alumni. He belongs to the very first batch of River. He has over 20 years of experience in the human vaccine industry and has worked in reputed WHO pre-qualified companies in the area of quality control, regulatory affairs and clinical trials, as well as pharmacovigilance. Currently, he is on a deputational role to the Food and Safety Standards Authority of India and is also the Joint Director. He is currently the Designated Officer and Central Licensing Authority for Food Licensing for the states of Tamil Nadu and Puducherry. We are extremely happy to welcome here today, sir. We are also happy to have with us all our students, faculty and parents on this very special day, where you will witness our students' achievements as well as our faculty's achievements and many more brilliant performances. We are very glad about your presence and we welcome you all here once again.
இவ்விழாவுக்கு வருகை தந்திருக்கும் நமது கௌரவ விருந்தினர் டாக்டர் கே ஏ அருள் ஆனந்த், FSSAI இணை இயக்குனர் தமிழ்நாடு மற்றும் புதுச்சேரி. இவர் நம் கல்லூரியின் முன்னாள் மாணவர் ஆவார் மற்றும் நமது கல்லூரியின் புல முதல்வர் டாக்டர் வி. செழியன் அவர்கள். பேராசிரியர்கள், ஊழியர்கள், மாணவர்கள் மற்றும் பெற்றோர்கள் அனைவரையும் அன்போடு வரவேற்கிறோம்.
On this auspicious occasion, I would request everyone to kindly stand for the Tamil Thaivaartham.
இவ்விழா சிறப்பாக நடைபெற எல்லாம் வல்ல இறைவனை வணங்குகிறோம். தொடக்கமாக தமிழ் தாய் வாழ்த்து.
வாழ்வினில் செம்மையை செய்பவள்ளியே, மாண்புகளே என் தமிழ் தாயே, வீழ்வாறு வீழாது காப்பவள்ளியே, வீரனின் வீரமும் வெற்றியும் நீயே, தாண்டிடு நிலையிலே உனை விடுப்பேனோ, தமிழ் என்னும் தலை குனிவேனோ, சூழ்ந்தின்பம் நல்கிடும் தமிழன்னாய் தோன்றுடல் நீ உயிர் நான் மறப்பேனோ, செந்தமிழே உயிரே நறுந்தேனே, செயலினை மூச்சினை உனக்களித்தேனே, நைந்தாயனில் நைந்து போகுமென் வாழ்வு நன்னிலை உனக்கெனில் எனக்கும் தானே, முந்திய நாளினில் அறிவும் இல்லாது மொய்த்தனன் மனிதராம் புதுப்புனல் மீது, செந்தாமரை காடு புத்தது போல செழித்த என் தமிழே ஒளியே வாழி, செழித்த என் தமிழே ஒளியே வாழி, செழித்த என் தமிழே ஒளியே வாழி.
As we move on to today's events, we are very glad to present to you the journey of River since the foundation of the institution in 1994. Join us as we follow the journey and the tremendous changes that have occurred over the past 30 years. We have been witnessing as this institution has grown tremendously under the guidance of each of the former deans and is now thriving under the leadership of our current dean, Dr. V. Serian. He has worked hard and taken this institute to great height, as well as had several major accomplishments that have never been before seen in the history of River. Please sit back quietly and enjoy this 15-minute video that showcases the highlights and achievements of our esteemed college in the past 30 years.
அடுத்ததாக நம் இன்றைய நிகழ்ச்சிகளை தொடங்குவதற்கு முன்னதாக நமது கல்லூரி கடந்து வந்த 30 ஆண்டுகளில் நடந்த நிகழ்வுகளை உங்களுக்கு முன்வைக்கிறோம். இந்த 30 ஆண்டுகளில் நம் கல்லூரி பல முன்னேற்றங்களையும் பல வெற்றிகளையும் கண்டுள்ளது. ஒரு சிறிய காணொளி மூலம் உங்களிடம் சமர்ப்பிக்கிறோம். நம் கல்லூரி பல புல முதல்வர்களின் தலைமையில் சிறந்த வளர்ச்சியை கண்டுள்ளது. தற்போதைய புல முதல்வர் டாக்டர் வி செழியன் நம் கல்லூரியின் வளர்ச்சிக்கு மிகவும் உறுதுணையாக இருப்பதால் கல்லூரி இப்பொழுது சிறப்பான வளர்ச்சியை அடைந்துள்ளது. அவரது வழிகாட்டுதலின்படி நமது கல்லூரி ஆராய்ச்சி துறையில் சிறப்பான முன்னேற்றம் கண்டுள்ளது. உங்களின் முயற்சிக்கு கல்லூரியின் சார்பில் நாங்கள் எங்கள் நன்றியை தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறோம். அனைவரையும் இந்த காணொளியை கண்டு மகிழுமாறு வேண்டுகிறோம்.
hope each and every one of you enjoyed watching the video showcasing all the hard work and the changes that have occurred over the last 30 years. Under the guidance of our team, the status of river has risen higher in the field of research and development. Thank you for all your efforts, sir. Now, to grace this occasion, three of our former deans, Dr. S. Tilagar sir, Dr. B. Ramesh Kumar sir, and Dr. S. Ramkumar sir, has sent their well wishes through a video message.
நமது கல்லூரியின் முந்தைய புல முதல்வர்கள் டாக்டர் எஸ் திலகர், டாக்டர் வி ரமேஷ்குமார், டாக்டர் எஸ் ராம்குமார் அவர்கள் தங்கள் வாழ்த்தினை காணொலி வாயிலாக தெரிவித்துள்ளனர். நாம் அதை இப்பொழுது காண்போம்.
On the foundation day of RIVA, I convey my best wishes and blessings to the students and the staff of this beautiful institute, which was first created as per the Council Act, Veterinary Council of India. I assumed the office of the Dean Rajiv Gandhi Institute of Veterinary Education and Research, Puducherry, on 27-7-2011 and occupied till 26-7-2014. I provided, to my understanding and the best of my effort, the best and convenient platform for the UG and PG educations in the field of veterinary education. The RAVCO was now renamed as RIVA during my tenure, that is Rajiv Gandhi Institute of Veterinary Education Research, has completed almost 30 years of its existence since its inception in 1994. The graduate of this college is now working in the various fields and in many countries. As a college dean, I have acted as a joint convener, UG Admission Committee of Puducherry Union Territory, that is called CENTAC, in the year 2012, 2013 and 2014. The college has done enormous service to these admission facilities of the Union Territory. As a recognition and proof of facilities, our college was able to obtain a NAC accreditation in the year 2013 and 14, first of its kind in the veterinary education. During my tenure, PG extension was extended in few more departments and many facilities were re-established for the benefits of the students, staff and the farming community. Drive was made for external funded research program activities and many staff members obtained funds from many agencies like Department of Science and Technology, Department of Biotechnology and NABARD. Fund for improvement of science and technology infrastructure in universities and higher education institutions, that is called FIST. An amount of 70 lakhs was obtained from the Government of India, DST, implemented between 2012 to 2014, which created many facilities in our college. I acted as a chief executive officer of this fund. Obtained an order with regards to the pension of retiring staff from the government of Puducherry and also signed a memorandum of understanding, MOU, with the National Meat and Poultry Processing Board, Ministry of Food Processing, Government of India, New Delhi, which caters a platform for training of professionals. Besides many funded projects, the source of revenue has been increased through NRI and payment cease admission. An attempt was made affiliate to the institution and ICAR, Government of India. I have created a conducive environment for all stakeholders of this institute for their education and the learning in general. I am saluting all the staff, students and earlier five deans including me and the present dean for the excellent effort contributions to nourish this institution. I wish you all a good luck. Jai Hind.
Dear faculty members, staff and students, I am delighted to join you in celebrating the World Foundation Day of the Rajiv Gandhi Institute of Veterinary Education and Research. This momentous occasion marks a significant milestone in the Institute's journey of excellence and commitment to the veterinary education research. The institute dedication to nurturing future veterinarians and advancing the field of veterinary medicine is truly commendable. Over the years, Rajiv Gandhi Institute has constantly produced skilled professionals who have made invaluable contribution to animal health and welfare. As we reflect on the institute's achievement, let us also look forward to the exciting possibility that lie ahead. I am confident that Rajiv Gandhi Institute will continue to be a beacon of innovation, knowledge and compassion in the years to come. On the special day, I extend my heartfelt congratulations to the entire Rajiv Gandhi Institute community. May you continue to inspire and empower generations of veterinarians to make a positive impact on the world. Wishing you all a joyous and memorable Foundation Day celebrations. Thank you.
Hello. It's a pleasure to be a part of the 30th birthday celebrations of our institute. 1994 was the year in which the foundation stone was laid. We are in 2024. Where are we as a river? I would say in the 3 decades, we have made tremendous progress. Teaching, research, extension, entrepreneurship. In a phased manner, I assume that we have been progressing based on the need of the time, technology and the region. Before I wind up and say all the best to this, let me put this. The most rewarding mail that I have got recently was from one of our alumni who was mentored for his postdoctoral by a present Nobel Prize winner. And the Nobel Prize winner is in his policy advisory board for his entrepreneurship company. This should open up your mind basically on what the opportunities are. When you study in river, where are your alumni? Get connected. And the get connected, I think, should be the key word of this Foundation Day as it advances. All the best to the dean, faculty, staff, and above all, the students who have consistently kept the prestigious name and the proud name of river in the globe map.
We are very grateful to have heard such words of encouragement from our former deans under whose leadership this institute has grown tremendously. I now request our respected chief guest, Dr. V. Sajjan, respected guest of honor, Dr. K. A. Arul Anand, associate patron of Student Council River, Dr. Avinash Lakavar, as well as the General Secretary of Student Council, Mr. Dhanush, and the Speaker of Student Council, Arya, to come up on the stage and grace the occasion.
மற்றும் மாணவர் பேரவையில் உறுப்பினர்கள், மாணவர் பேரவையின் சபாநாயகர் மற்றும் அவர்களை அழைக்கிறோம்.
I now request our respected dean to kindly felicitate the guest of honor with a shawl and a bouquet.
நமது கல்லூரியின் புலமுதல்வர் டாக்டர் வி செலியன் அவர்கள், நமது கௌரவ விருந்தினர் டாக்டர் அருளானந்த் இணை இயக்குனர் FSSAI தமிழ்நாடு மற்றும் புதுச்சேரி அவர்களை கௌரவிப்பார்.
The associate patron of the student council, Dr. Avinash Lakavar, to felicitate our chief guest, Dr. V. Sajjan, with a bouquet.
மாணவர் பேரவையின் அசோசியேட் பேட்ரன் டாக்டர் அவினாஷ் லக்காவர் அவர்கள், நமது கல்லூரியின் புலமுதல்வர் டாக்டர் வி செலியன் அவர்களை கௌரவிப்பார்.
I now request the Speaker of the Student Council River, Ms. Arya, to felicitate the Associate Patron with a bouquet.
மாணவர் பேரவையின் சபாநாயகரை நமது அசோசியேட் பேட்ரன் டாக்டர் அவினாஷ் லதாவர் சார் அவர்களை கௌரவிப்பார்.
I now request the speaker student council river Ms. Arya Nambiar to deliver the welcome address.
வரவேற்புரை வழங்க மாணவர் பேரவையின் சபாநாயகர் செல்வி ஆர்யா நம்பியார் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம்.
A very good evening to all of you. Today is not just a day on the calendar. Today is a celebration of the heart, of history, and of hope. I, Arya Nambiar, Speaker of the Student Council of River, stand here representing the voice of the students, and I'm filled with immense pride and gratitude, not just for this institution, but for every single person who has walked through its gates. Welcome to the 30th Foundation Day of our college. 30 years ago, a vision was born, a vision that we are now a part of. What started as a dream has transformed into an institution that doesn't just teach veterinary science. It creates leaders, thinkers, and change makers. This college, our college, stands tall today because of the sacrifices, passion, and unwavering dedication of those who came before us, our founders, our faculty, and our alumni. First and foremost, I extend a warm and heartfelt welcome to our chief guest, our beloved Dean, Dr. Sejian Sir. Your leadership, vision, and commitment have been instrumental in steering our college towards greater heights. Under your guidance, we have seen remarkable progress in both academic excellence and student growth. Thank you for gracing this occasion and constantly inspiring us to strive for more. Welcome, sir. I would also like to extend a special welcome to our guest of honor, Dr. Arul Anand, sir. It is an absolute privilege to have you with us today. Your presence is a testament to the deep connections that we share with leaders, experts, and distinguished individuals who believe in the power of education, service, and community. We are honored to have you here, sir. Welcome. I'd also like to extend my most heartfelt welcome to our associate patrons of the Student Council, Dr. Avinash Lakhtavar, sir, and Dr. Bharti Raja, sir. Sir, we thank you for your constant support and welcome, sir. To our esteemed faculty members, the backbone of this institution, a very warm welcome. It is your dedication and passion that fuel the academic rigor and holistic development of every student here. Thank you for your unwavering support and for being the guiding force behind all that we achieve. Now, I would also like to welcome members of the non-teaching staff and the engineering cell, and I'd like to thank them for their constant support. To our esteemed alumni, welcome back to where it all began. You carry the name of this institution into the world, and your achievements are a constant reminder of what is possible. You have shown us that no dream is too big, no challenge too daunting. Your legacy is the roadmap that we follow, and we look to you with admiration and hope for our own futures. Welcome to your alumni. A very warm welcome to all the sponsors of today's event. All of this would not have been possible without your contributions towards our college. A very special welcome to all the parents present here. Your belief in this institution and your continuous support for your children's dreams have been invaluable. Today, we share this celebration with you because the foundation of every student's success is built upon encouragement and guidance. We are deeply honored by your presence. And to my fellow students, the future of this institution, let me say this. We are the heartbeat of this college. We are the energy, the innovation, and the force that will shape the next 30 years. Our journey here is not just about textbooks and exams. It's about discovering who we are, who we want to be, and the impact that we want to leave on this world. As the Speaker of the Students' Council, I stand before you, not just as your representative, but as a reflection of all that we have achieved together. This year has been extraordinary, from the highs of our cultural fest Riveria to the day-to-day moments of collaboration and growth. We've shown that we are capable of greatness when we come together, whether it's in celebrating our heritage or pushing the boundaries of science and innovation. But today isn't just about looking back at what has been. It's about looking forward. It's about the next chapter, the next generation, the next great leap that this college will take. And guess what? That's us. We are the ones who will carry this institution's legacy and name forward. It is in our hands now. So, let's dream bigger than ever before. Let's challenge ourselves not just to be good students, but to be compassionate veterinarians, responsible citizens, and fearless leaders. Let us continue the legacy of this institution by pushing the boundaries of what's possible in the world of veterinary science and beyond. Now, we are living in 30 years of history, but it's just the beginning. The next 30 years will be shaped by us, by our courage and curiosity, and also by our commitment to making the world a better place, one step at a time, one animal at a time, and one innovation at a time. To all present here, thank you for being a part of this momentous occasion. Together, we celebrate not just an institution, but a legacy of excellence and humanity that will continue to thrive in all of us. Here's to 30 incredible years, and here's to the future that's waiting for us to create. Thank you, and welcome once again to our 30th Foundation Day.
Thank you, Arya, for your kind and welcoming word. It was once said, knowledge will give you power, but character will give you the respect you deserve. In character, in manner, status, in all things, the supreme excellence is simplicity. I invite our respected Joint Director, FSSAI, Tamil Nadu and Puducherry, Dr. K. A. Arul Anand, to kindly address the gathering.
சிறப்புரை வழங்குவதற்காக நமது கௌரவ விருந்தினர் டாக்டர் அருள் ஆனந்த் இணை இயக்குனர் FSSAI தமிழ்நாடு மற்றும் புதுச்சேரியை அன்போடு அழைக்கிறோம்.
குட் ஈவினிங், வணக்கம். ரெஸ்பெக்டட் டீன், ஆல்சோ வெரி குட் ஃப்ரெண்ட் ஆஃப் மை டாக்டர் செழியன், ரெஸ்பெக்டட் டீச்சர்ஸ், ரெஸ்பெக்டட் my teachers who are here, respected parents, the student council members, and the students. I it's a nostalgic feeling for me. I am in my college. I joined this college 30 years before, and here on the 30th Foundation Day. So it's a great honor for me. In fact, I was, you know, thinking myself when Dean invited me for this, am I really eligible to come here and then do this? But then Dean insisted, and my good friends also insisted that I come and participate. So it's a great honor, it's a great pleasure for me to be here and address this gathering. It's a beautiful evening. I understand the program was supposed to be done on 14th October, but then because of the rains, but it was a consistent follow by Dean and also by my friends who are here to come and participate. So I made it up to come here today evening and then, you know, I give this guest of honor speech, which I for myself feel really, you know, am I eligible. To begin with, this 30 years, this college, to see the question what it has achieved, what we saw as a presentation today, and it is a tremendous achievement. How Raghakovas has migrated to river, and what achievements we have made. I'd like to say a few words. I totally understand it's going to be a fun-filled evening for the students. I don't want to give a long speech and then spoil your evening. I understand that you look forward for your cultural events. I'll give a very short speech and then conclude. I need to specially talk about your dean and also my very good friend Dr. Sherian, and the humble beginnings that we had. You know, this is something which I wanted to share. Dr. Sherian stays slightly far away from my place, and I remember those days when we joined college, that we used to come and cycle to my home, and from there we both used to walk together to the bus stand, the college bus stop, and then we used to board the bus. You know, from such humble beginnings, to see what Dr. Sedian has achieved today and what he has been doing for this college is really a great achievement. I request all the students to give a big round of applause to your dean. you know, for all the achievements that he is doing. You know, I've not been that connected to what is happening in the college, but what I could understand from my friends is the developments that is happening here in terms of the postgraduate studies that have been brought in, new labs that have been set up, a central instrumentation lab that has been set up, and externship program for the students. You know, I would tell you all students, you have to be really be privileged to have a dean and faculty of this kind. You need to be really, really be privileged, because such kind of exposure was not there when we were in college those days. Now, it is really surprising for me that there is an externship program where, you know, students can go and participate, be practicing there to understand the nature as how things work there. All that has happened because of the dean's effort. I could see the number of collaborations that has been made with various international universities. So those are all really great achievements, sir. I'm overwhelmed to see such type of developments happening in this college. And to say how we began with, you know, like, I don't know how many of those staff would have shared that we started the single room as our classroom. That was the kind of a borrowed facility of Pond Lake. So our classroom was that. And I remember our founder, Dean Dr. Sabrinathan Iyer now, and to the efforts that he made to ensure that nothing, we didn't lack anything. You know, he ensured that everything is in place. I still remember when I was seeing this run-through video about the progression of the college, there was some, you know, standby buildings that were made. Ironically, what happened was the buildings were developed and we were supposed to enter into the building the next day, but the previous night there was a heavy rain. And to our utter dismay, that buildings collapsed. But our dean at that point of time ensured that, you know, it comes up immediately, and then he ensured that, you know, we are continuously on the go. He ensured that nothing stopped. All the facilities were made available, and we continued studying. So if we look back today as how we progressed, how the college has developed, it's really a very good feeling. And so with this, I really thank the dean once again for calling me for this event. And secondly, to all my respected teachers, my teachers are still here. I need to thank them. I also need to apologize to them. I need to thank them because, you know, it's because the teachers that I'm here, as whatever I have achieved today, it's because of my teachers. I need to apologize to them because I have never been a good student. You know, I've been kind of, you know, person who is kind of a last bench. I also have my partner in crime. He's one of the professors here, Dr. Kantaraj. So we were always together, and oh, that's a big round of applause for him. I don't know where he is. We were always together. He was my schoolmate, my college mate, and will be my mate for life. So my friend, good friend. So he made it a point. He told, I will send a card for you. I'll send whatever you need, I'll do. Please come and participate in the program. So like, when I was speaking about the teachers, we were not really good. I could understand. At this age, I could feel like how my teachers would have felt that when we were so mischievous in the classroom. But thank you to all my teachers who have helped us and then brought us to this stage. To all the non-teaching and administrative staff, I could see all the drivers here who were there, who used to take us all along for all the trips that we had, and picking us from the stops and dropping us in the college. All that, happy to see all of them here and then still staying in the college and then supporting the college in a very nice way. And to the student council members, a very elaborate arrangement that what you people are doing. During our days, we didn't have such type of setup and arrangement, but then what you people are doing today, I think a big round of applause to the student council, the speaker, and General Secretary. I remember, so I was also speaker I held the position. I'm not sure which position I. So you have done a very, very beautiful evening today. So this is what I had to share to all my other friends. You know, Dr. Venkatesh Perumal, who's always been a disciplined person from those days in college till today. He has been a disciplined person. Another friend, Dr. Raj Kumar, I don't know how many of you know that he's a he was an excellent dancer, you know. So he used to rock in stage, you know, such a and he's an even today, you know, like when we were discussing, we used to say he's a permanent student, you know. He has that curiosity to learn. He's a person who can talk on all subjects. So Dr. Raj Kumar there, and then Dr. Abhirami. So he was in the same group. When we attended clinics, like we were a group of five. Unfortunately, I was the only, the other people were all ladies. So, but then still, you know, Dr. Abhirami was always there as a good, colleague and partner. So that's one good thing. And there are few, I felt that I should also be remembering few people here. Which is, of course, a sad feeling for me. We had two good friends they left us early. One was Prabhu, our classmate who left us somewhere in the second year, and one of my very good friends, Dr. Jasjit, who was not only a good college friend, but he was also my official colleague. We were working together for quite some time. So today on this day, because I'm in this college, I couldn't deliver a speech without mentioning them. My prayers for my friends who left us early. And to all the students here, my one good advice that I would give you is, please make this college, this institute proud. You all have a responsibility. The dean is making so much of effort to give you all the resources, all the visibility that you need, that is being created by the dean. So you have a beautiful faculty. I know my teachers, so how they have groomed us. I know for sure they are grooming you all very well. So you have a responsibility towards this college, and you should make this institute proud. Wherever you go, you should make this institute proud. Regarding the profession that we are in, the course that we study, I for myself, I could understand, like, veterinary service, veterinary education itself is a very rugged thing, you know, like you will fit anywhere once you go out of the college. For people who are interested in academics, please continue with your academics and then finish it till the point that you want to finish. But people who want to enter the industry, again, by virtue of what little experience that I have in industry, a veterinarian will fit anywhere. You want to be in marketing, you want to be in production, quality control, quality assurance, you want to be on a regulatory role as what I am doing, you will fit everywhere. So you have a lot of scope available outside, but then you have to make best use of this particular institute and all the resources that the dean and the faculty are making making it available to you. I would request all of you to, you know, use these resources. That's what I'm saying. I again go back. We didn't have such type of facilities those days. But what the dean has brought in here in terms of all the facilities, the number of photographs, the number of events that has happened in this college, it's really amazing to see. So I would request all of you to make all this, make use of all these resources and make this college proud. With this, I'm not sure whether I missed something, but with this, I would finish my talk. I wish all the students the very best in your future. I wish my prayers to all my teachers here. My wishes to all the administrative and the non-technical staff. My congratulations to the student council for having arranged a beautiful program. And also to the associate patron, sorry sir. Sir was also behind me to come and participate in this program. So I've never been this formal in this college. So today I'm feeling it really, you know, kind of delicate to be so formal and then delivering this speech. Thank you very much. All the very best. I wish River all the very best. Thank you.
Thank you for your humble words of encouragement, sir. Your words have really lightened up the mood here. We all are aware that the success of any educational institution depends on the head of that institution. Our dean is the driving force who manages, coordinates, guides and supervises various activities of this institute. It's my honor to welcome our beloved dean, Dr. V. Sejian, to present the annual report of RIVA.
இக்கல்லூரியின் தலைமை பொறுப்பேற்று அதன் முன்னேற்றத்திற்காக பாடுபடும் நமது கல்லூரியின் புலம் முதல்வர் டாக்டர் வி செலியன் அவர்களை ஆண்டு அறிக்கை வாசிக்க அன்போடு அழைக்கிறோம்.
My non-teaching staff and my students and also the unskilled laborers, a very hearty 30th Foundation Day celebration of RIVA, Raghavas alias RIVA. At the outset, let me again tell that we couldn't make it this time any big VIPs like our Honorable Agriculture Minister and as well as our Honorable Secretary Animal Husbandry because of their very busy schedule now currently going on, especially with the finance distribution and other things, so they could not able to make it this year. But then our Honorable Agriculture Minister conveyed his best wishes for all the faculty, staff and students, and also our Honorable Animal Husbandry Secretary Raju sir also conveyed his congratulations and best wishes on the occasion of 30th Foundation of RIVA. Before I start, and let me fondly remember the contributions made by our great deans of this prestigious institute, as echoed by our guest of honor today, Dr. Arulanand, our founder dean, who has been an instrumental, who is a visionary, and I believe that what we are today, it is the seed sown by him. It's important that we remember what all his tremendous contribution, especially from the starting of from the scratch and then building this institute what it is today. And he made an immense contribution as far as the growth of Raghavas alias RIVA is concerned. And next, Dr. G. Bucheya, the second dean of this prestigious institute, who have really taken to the next level of starting the PG program as well as the infrastructure development wise, because it's tremendous progress he has made. Before I commence further, I would request all of you to stand for a 1 minute silence of these two late deans of our prestigious institute. As a token of respect, let us mark 1 minute silence for paying our tribute to what they have achieved for our sake, and then also what is their contribution to see this institute in reality what it is today. Thank you so much. Most respected all the head of the departments, my dear faculty members, and all the non-teaching staff of this prestigious institute, and all the unskilled laborers who is toiling hard to take this institute forward, and above all, the most important resources of this college, the student fraternity here, who are present over here. A very, very warm good evening to all of you, and also happy 30th Foundation Day celebrations to all of you. And I also make it on record my sincere appreciation to all the parents who have come from various parts to encourage their kids as well as to see and support this institute in whatever way today it is. Let me heartily welcome each and every one of you. My dear friend as well as the guest of honor today, Dr. Arulanand, was been a very good support for this institute last 3 years after I took over, because whatever help we have requested him, he has been very kind enough and then very down to earth personality. And as he mentioned already that I also joined with him to see that we are backbenchers, and today you can see that what is the achievement today he has made. And I also wanted to give him a big round of applause, all the students especially, for what he is today, because the FSSI, the registration for the river came under his visionary guidance, and he has been instrumental in getting this certification for our institute, which is one of the important recognition from the Puducherry government also, when we got the best institute award, because FSSI registration is something very, very big thing for an institute like river, because we are selling a lot of milk and meat products. So he has been very kind enough for us to process that application, and he was instrumental in getting that done for our institute. And our memory goes back, and then you know, like, we are also backbenchers, both of us. And then as he has already summarized that how a nostalgic moments he has created, really his speech was outstanding today, because that is coming from his heart, and then he has not prepared anything, and then very straightforward he is thanking all his teachers, as we always do, that we come and respect our teachers, and then mark our token of appreciation for whatever they have contributed, because we know how tough it was for us in 1994 to start the journey in this prestigious institute, and then with a very, very minimal facility. That is why he is echoing what I always keep telling to my students, like, make use of this atmosphere what is currently prevailing with the quality teaching, and as well as the infrastructure in terms of research facilities that this institute is seeing currently, and the various opportunities that we are providing, because those days that was not the case for us. Like in that way, I feel like it's a very apt to have on the 30th foundation day such a guest of honor for us, for Dr. Erlanand, for making it all the way in spite of 2 times postponing. You know, he's a very, very busy guy there at Chennai. And because when we approached him for the first, he was very hesitant, because, you know, like, he's very shy type of person, and he continues to be so like that. And he was also our first class representative of our class, and a very, very close attachment we used to have. And you know, like, the company of Dr. Gantharaj, you all can understand, like, what type of group we are. So, and then also Dr. Rajkumar, because I still believe that for our first foundation day, I mean, we wanted to celebrate. So in Erlanand's home is the hub for all of us. So Dr. Erlanand's home will be spoiled by all of us. We break chairs, everything. For the first time in my life also, I also danced for a song in this college. That is because of him. Because we used to practice in late night, and then we all used to gather together, no facilities like this. And then it's such a very important moment. Even our founder speaker of student council, Dr. Karthikeyan, was also very close with us. We all culminate in his home, have a weekend celebrations. So we thoroughly enjoy all those nostalgic moments he brought when he started discussing about all these things. Due to the constraint of time, I leave it here, because he has already summed it up, what is this, the 30-year journey is all about. And I also take this opportunity to congratulate Associate Patron, who has been toiling hard to bring this into reality. There was a slight hiccup today morning, and then, but then we could see that an alternative person have been roped in, and then in a record three and a half hours time. And we must give a big round of applause to Tiago and team for getting the last minute offer, and then accepting the challenge, and then with the rain god threatening us, and then he has made it a tremendous contribution. And I also wanted to make a record my sincere appreciation all the staffs, non-teaching staff and the unskilled employees who have toiled hard to see this stage into reality in about 3 hours time. So they all require a big round of applause for the celebration to mark. I also want to place on my record my sincere appreciation to the speaker, Ms. Arya, and then the General Secretary, Mr. Danush, and the Cultural Secretary, Harini, as well as all other student council members. Because I must say, like, it's always possible, like, we records are meant to be broken, and we also always keep crossing our own boundaries. This team has done tremendously well this year to take the Riveria to the very next level. As last week, we have witnessed some of the wonderful talents exhibiting and portraying what they have seen today. You are going to see the results of those things, as well as the salient performances of those will be displayed for the audience today. And let me go to the annual report. This is customary for any head of institute to read through what all the achievements the institute has made last 1 year. And just an history, 1994, October 14th was our birthday. And then since then, it is now 30 years we have completed. It is the first veterinary college to be under the Veterinary Council of India. It is accredited to NAC as well as ICAR and UGC. And we are offering BBSC and MUSC in 13 disciplines now, and three more disciplines are in pipeline, genetics and breeding, and pharmacology and toxicology, and as well as MUSC in veterinary biotechnology also will be started shortly in a while, in 2 months' time. And also happy to mention that we have also started a lot of short-term and diploma as well as short-term courses now. And also we are intake of about 100 students, roughly about 500 odd UG students, and about 40 odd PG students are enrolled. The most important thing is that 56 very excellent faculty that we are having today, because you know, like the culture of this river, wherever we go, Dr. Harlanan, this is a very good history. Three generations are sitting here. One generation have left us, the other generation are leading us as in terms of teachers, in terms of head of the departments, and also we colleagues are in next line, also the next generation, as Arya very beautifully put it in her message, welcome address, that they are going to be the torch bearer for the next 30 years. And this is a baton that we wanted to pass on to the next student council also. Approximately 50% of the students are coming from outside. That is another, like, similar to that of the faculty distribution. You know, the biggest advantage this institute has seen, which, because it's a mini India in terms of both faculty as well as the student, that brings in a very, very unique culture here, because we are culturally different, but then we are united in terms of river. And the credit goes to all the head of the departments, previous head of the departments, and the current head of the department, and also the most senior faculties, and most importantly, the contract faculty are also, who are doing immensely good to this institute in terms of imparting quality teaching. That is the reason globally the alumni are distributed, and also wherever we go, we are the most sought after students, especially Mecca, like for veterinarians in India, that is IVRI. People choose veterinary graduates who are coming from Pondicherry, because that is the quality that we bring in on table when we are going for the higher studies. And also the admission process is very transparent. It is controlled by completely CENTAC 100% admission, with 15% seat from Indian Veterinary Council of India, and also about almost 95% of grad students are wanting to pursue PG program. That is another landmark that always river gives value to the PG programs as well. And also student engage themselves in extracurricular activities, and today event is also one of the typical example of how we evolved in last 30 years in terms of building the extracurricular activities in our students. So far, 1,147 students have emerged, graduated from this prestigious institute, and our alumni are very well placed across the globe, including USA, Canada, UK, France, Australia, South Korea, etc. Now, moving to the second part of my discussion, that is the significant achievement of our institute in last 1 year. Talking about the significant achievement, ever since the institute has been bestowed with the Best Institute Award in Puducherry in 2023, our responsibility have grown multifold, and it has increased our focus on the students' overall development of the institute. And we wanted to give our students the best possible atmosphere, very, very conducive for learning. And for the better teaching and learning, what the institute have done in last 1 year, all classrooms were air-conditioned and internet-enabled digital smart boards were installed by providing new learning experience for the students. Two new classrooms of 150 and 120 capacity respectively were constructed during this period and inaugurated. Construction of a new examination hall has just been completed and will be inaugurated shortly. Internship allowance for the UG students, the stipend for the PG students, and funds for the students' research has been hiked enormously, and a timely distribution of these funding for the students, especially the PG, is one of the which gives every fifth, just like a salary, the PG scholarship. Not any other institute among the veterinary institutes in the country is doing that. We have also signed MOU with 11 foreign universities and 6 national research institutes, along with Goshala and Aura Foundation, enabling students to undertake a 1 month externship program in foreign university, carry out part of PG in other institutes, and have a scientist from a foreign university or a national research institute in PG advisory committee. And concentrating more on bringing out quality joint publications with international experts in high impact peer-reviewed journals and better form exposure, all leading to producing quality outgoing graduates from our institute. In this connection, I'm happy to mention here that one PG student from pathology visited Cambridge University to carry out part of his PG research program. Because of the MOU, 20 students visited two university in Australia and one university in Italy last year for 1 month externship. This year, 4 students went to University of Connecticut, USA for externship, while unfortunately 16 students could not make it due to visa issue to Italy. Proud to mention here that our institute is the only institute in the country providing an abroad exposure to the students in enormous number, because there are certain universities we know they send 1 or 2 toppers, but then here we don't mind about it because we are now equipped even to send up to 70 students very easily through these MOUs. And thanks to the Honorable Chief Minister for making it bigger in the coming year, because he always wanted this program to be continued, because that gives a huge recognition even for the other colleges in terms of motivation. The students every year also undertake South India and All India tour for better exposure as well as for learning. And in terms of research facility, because in river is growing now, the R in the river stands for research, and we really wanted to concentrate on taking river to the international arena. When I took over as the dean of this prestigious institute, one thing I was making a point that I want to put this prestigious institute in the global map with a the river has concentrated on increasing the infrastructure for the research. In that aspect, the Center for Translational Research, to cater the need of the farmer in terms of bringing out a product so that the ultimate target group of the farmers will be benefited enormously, have been constituted or established in with a 2 crore facility special drive by our Honorable Chief Minister. We should give him a big round of applause to seeing that in reality today. And that has been put in use now. All the sister institutes in the Puducherry as well as also using such facility. And also we have another bringing this new ECC inaugurated shortly at River Campus. You can see that a lot of activities goes on in the clinics, and you know, like they toil hard, and then they are the face of River, because ultimately the final 2 years are crucial in any veterinary profession, because whatever we learn, the basics have to be applied, and then the ultimate, the poor animal resources, their welfare need to be ensured. They play an immense role. What we thought of, like, we need to, I played a special role here because I wanted to always, I also always wanted to make it a point that the clinical facilities need to be spot on, because Puducherry is very famous for rearing pet animals and pet birds, and also the poor and marginal farmers are enormous. So we need to really have a good diagnostic system in place. In that aspect, the new VCC has been erupted here, and then tremendous achievement that is, in my opinion, because to keep all the faculty under one roof, otherwise they keep traveling because a lot of activities they do here and then there, and then that is earmarked for roughly about 60 odd students. Managing is very difficult, but then we wanted to give them also a better facility like in the main campus. So now a full-fledged new TVCC have been established, and it is put into function, and all the teachers in the clinics especially are very happy, and I will continue to support the clinical people, because we know, like, we need more facility, and I'm trying my level best to add more facilities in the short while from now. And let us make the public of Puducherry use this opportunity, and then give a quality advanced diagnostic facilities so that we can ensure animal welfare in the state. And another breakthrough achievement last year was the Pondicherry government listened to our request and then sanctioned about 1.5 crore for establishing a regional center at Karaikal, which will be primarily put into use for training as well as research activities, because you know, like, there's substantial population of livestock at the Karaikal region. We wanted to cater the need of the Karaikal farmers, so with that intention this is getting established. And happy news is that it is almost getting finalized. Maybe in the first week of November we'll be going for an inauguration of Karaikal regional center to cater the need of the poor and marginal farmer. We wanted to do a door-to-door ambulatory system establishment and then making an impact. So a team is will be spearheaded by Professor Murugvel sir, and there will be very shortly putting the team into use, and then all the internee students from the Karaikal region, their parents will be very happy, because we wanted to put all those internship students who belong into Karaikal in the center, so that they will be imparting quality training and treatment protocols for the poor animal resources. And in a long run, we wanted to establish a IVF facilities, so that next 4 years Murugvel sir wanted to establish an IVF facility there, so that we wanted to make an inroad into reproductive research to improve the reproductive efficiency of the animals in the Karaikal region. And many modernization works were also taken up in the institute during the last 1 year. There are like 5 research projects were sanctioned with external funding. All our faculty, especially the young faculty, are after external funded research project. I must say that all the contract faculties have made an immense role in this, because there are a lot of progressive contract faculty among us, and we are with you always. We have our support are there always, because you make us proud through these research projects. And also recently, one of the research project from the Veterinary Public Health and Epidemiology on all India basis, competition basis, we won from the Ministry of Education. And one international conference, ISS, Indian Society for Study of Goat Production and Utilization, conducted in last April. And also one national conference on veterinary cardiology, and one international workshop sponsored by the Commonwealth Veterinary Association in Australia have been conducted. We also will be conducting 2 more international conferences, one by the World Veterinary Poultry Association conference in the month of February, and Society for Animal Physiology in India conference in 2025, and one more conference is also pipeline, especially Indian Society for Animal Reproduction. And Commonwealth Veterinary Association have helped us to establish 2 international centers, one for animal welfare, and which is established in the LPM department, and the other one is the Advanced Diagnostic Facility Laboratory for the rabies, which is established in the Department of Veterinary Public Health and Epidemiology. And also happy to inform that many scientists from USA, France, Australia and other countries are visiting River for delivering various lectures and motivational talks to the students. And the institute also conducted about 12 training programs last 1 year, sponsored by DST, NABARD and DRDA, for the benefit of farmers of Puducherry and women self-help group. And Department of Veterinary Surgery have conducted a training program on large animal anesthesia and surgery, and also Department of Public Health have conducted drawing competition on rabies awareness students for government school, and also student research initiatives, such as we have also introduced for the undergraduates student research, which is first of its kind in the country. And from students' side, they are encouraged to participate in conferences. Happy to mention that 60 students, UG students, have participated in last 1 year in various conferences and presenting papers and winning awards as well. Recently, the PG students from veterinary pathology have won 6 prizes. Almost all the participants of PG students in the pathology department won 6 prizes in the recent conference held at Karnataka. The students are also encouraged to write a review as well as research article. Happy to mention few of our students are really publishing very high impacted journal now. You are going to witness in the award ceremony that that is a very encouraging news for us and for the mentors. In total, about 38 students out of 60 in last year have taken a PG program. On the administration front, after introducing the biometric system for first of its kind in Puducherry, both the UG and PG students, and then as recommended by the VCA also, well before that, we have inaugurated the facility in the state, which means we are setting the tone for veterinary education in the country. And also we have brought in display boards in all departments with a unique projection of uniformly all the academic achievements, research outputs, project details and awards received in the form manner of all the departments, very uniquely we portrayed. Encouragement to the faculty and staff, lot of new initiative in last 1 year the institute has taken, especially to bring in a competitive spirit among the workers in various sectors, and that has culminated in various student awards, award for the best academic performance with the highest GPA in each year. Overall best academic performance by the highest GPA and best performer in all India ICR PG entrance examination, and then award to the student who excels in academics as well as sports and games, overall all-rounder award, and the student research award both for the UG category and PG category, and also best review article by UG and PG students, best teacher award selected by the students, faculty research and review paper award, best technology award, because we are also encouraging best technology to come up, and best faculty who contributing to the institutional building building activities enormously for seeing the growth of river. And also in this year, we have introduced, you are going to witness a short while from now, that non-teaching staff award in various categories. And also the best department award also been introduced in here. And I want to make an announcement as the dean of this college, like every year the best department award is going to be very, very important, because the head of the department holds a special responsibility, and they have to move towards the scorecard that has been developed and done to build the institute, because we really wanted to show output to the various funding agency as well as to the Puducherry government. In that aspect, I want to make an announcement that from this year onwards, the best department award is given, and they will be given 5 lakhs from the institute funding, so that they can they will be getting any facility of their department requirement from the 5 lakhs. And also long pending promotion cases for 6 of our non-teaching staff have been accomplished this year. And also we have renovated completely the herbal garden for 20th September this year, and we also recently got a first prize in the Farmers Fest celebrated by the Puducherry government. On the hospital front, our hospital service, our VCC serves as a referral veterinary hospital in and around Puducherry, and has all the clinical departments with modern laboratory diagnostic facilities. On an average, around 100 cases per day are treated in the hospital. The ambulatory clinic with a team of experts diagnoses and treats various cases at farmers' doorsteps in the village. In addition, in patient wards and in health care wards are available. In the last year, ultrasound and x-ray unit were procured. Dr. Arulajyothi ma'am always requested me for last 2 years, and that has been put into use now in reality to strengthen the diagnostic facility. And 4 animal health camps were organized in last 1 year, benefiting many farmers. More and more will be planned in the coming year. Next week, medicine department also is organizing one more such event. All these initiatives are auguring well for the institute. There is a good competitive spirit prevailing among the students and the faculty. Everyone is wanting to excel in academics and extracurricular activities. We are happy to mention here the number of students who got first class in distinction among the graduating students have gone from 15% to 22% last year. In the coming year, I am confident that that number will further go up. Happy also to mention here that in last 2 years, 2 students of our institute have got admission to direct PhD program in USA with a fellowship and a tuition fee waiver, and also 1 student for masters in Canada. And also proud to mention here that our students are also excelling in sports and games. Many students are doing the institute proud by participating at the university level, as well as a few participating at the national level as well. In addition to this, our students do not miss any opportunity to participate in nation building activities through NSS. They participate in election awareness campaign, animal health awareness rallies, and beach cleaning programs, etc. The future plans are more externally funded research project on competitive grant based from our young and energetic faculty for self-sustainable mode to take to river. Recruitment of additional faculty, which we are strongly working on. Very, very shortly, we will be having some good news to go for the notification. And more MOU with more foreign universities with a focus on training young faculty members, not only for the students. And dairy product incubation center, which will be initiated shortly under the PMFME scheme, and construction of extra lunch shed for catering the need of more number of the students for the benefit of the students, and relaying of the internal road. Happy to share that our honorable MP, government of India, the Pondicherry representative, have sanctioned 13 lakhs. Okay, so like we will very shortly starting the relaying of road in the main campus. So that is a very big achievement in last week that has happened. And also hostel accommodation for accommodating 200 boys and 200 girls. We are almost there. Our executive engineer, whose contribution should never be forgotten in the history of river, because he's been instrumental in preparing the DPR. And once we get a final nod, now we are almost in the verge of achieving that auditorium, so that we no need to worry about the rain god or something like that. Every year on the foundation day itself, our program can go. The 1,000 capacity auditorium and 200 capacity boys hostel and 200 capacity girls hostel, and also 5 classrooms of 150 capacity with all modern teaching aids, is that it will be a dream come true. I am sure like we are almost there, and in next couple of months we should be there achieving the target of 44 crores from the Puducherry government. And also release of fund for pension have been streamlined last 1 year. I must put it on record, like we have almost released about 8 crore in last 1 year with around 5.8 crore from the internal revenue and about 2.5 crore from the grant in aid from the Pondicherry government. Slowly and steadily we are making the progress, and we are at it, and it takes little bit of time to streamline. I'm sure, like before all the current faculty retires, I'm sure everything will be coming into reality. And I would urge all my faculty to be rallying behind me to keep patience on that, because we really need to streamline that. And two proposals of projects have been submitted for funding to National Livestock Mission by Dr. George Dominic of 4.5 crore. And then also we wanted to establish advanced veterinary diagnostic facility, which is worth around 2 crore, which is in pipeline. And also one at the IVF center at the Karaikal region, worth 3.5 crore. I'm happy that we are in a very good position to produce outstanding graduates who are not only good in academics, but also in overall development. I must also mention here that because of the series of student-centric measures, we are taking the visibility of the institute as improved manifold, and also demand for the UG and PG programs are continuously on the rise. Many students from other states prefer our institute and over other leading institute for their higher education and in quota admission. Lastly, I would like to say that this is the in our memory, this is the first time that the last year's first mark was the this year's, in this 1 year I'm talking about the last mark for the admission that has already resulted. And happy to note from the CSE of River, Uma Maheshwari ma'am, that all of them have cleared, all the 100 students have cleared their first year, which is very rare to come by because of the high meritoriousness of the students. With these few words, I once again take this opportunity to thank each and everyone who played an immense role, starting from a brick, and each and everyone, the non-teaching staff, including and the unskilled employees, and above all the my predecessors, the deans, and also my previous head of the departments and our current head of the departments, and then the faculty who play toil hard, because predominantly our faculty does the work in the institute in terms of both infrastructure development as well as institutional building activities. I wish that with this type of encouragement for the non-teaching staff, I also wanted them to be on board with us so that we can take River to the more glory in the years to come. And I take this opportunity to thank each and every one of you for contributing immensely for the growth of this institute. And let us continue the good work and cherish the memory of being in one of the prestigious institute in India, arguably in near future in the world also. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir, for briefing us on the activities and achievement of the institute, and also for making clear our institute's goal with such concision and clarity. We are blessed to have the likes of you leading the institute. Thank you, sir.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have now reached a very important and solemn part of the evening. We will now be commencing with the prize distribution ceremony. The River Management has previously introduced several accolades for the students as well as the faculty to encourage them in academics as well as to instill research development in the institute. We are pleased to bestow this honor upon the recipients of these awards.
இப்பொழுது மிகவும் முக்கியமான தருணம், பரிசுகள் மற்றும் விருதுகள் வழங்கும் தருணம்.
Begin with the awards for the faculty that have worked hard and given their time and efforts to our prestigious institution. These faculty have completed 25 years of their dedicated service, and we are thankful for all the hard work that you have put into this institution and are very glad to honor you with this award. I request all the council members to currently be on the stage.
நமது கல்லூரியில் பணிபுரிந்து 25 ஆண்டுகள் நிறைவு செய்த பேராசிரியர்கள், ஊழியர்கள் அவர்களை கௌரவிக்கும் விதமாக நினைவு பரிசு வழங்குகிறோம்.
begin with the awards. The first person to receive the 25 Years of Service Award is Dr. H.K. Mukhopadhyay, Professor and Head, Department of Veterinary Microbiology, Liverpool.
Dr. H.K. Mukhopadhyay avargalai medaikku alaikkirom. பேராசிரியர் டாக்டர் விஜே அஜய்குமார் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். Completed their 25 years in river. First, திரு கே பாபு அவர்கள் யூடிசி அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். திரு வாசுதேவன் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். ஆரிமுத்து அவர்களை நேரடி அழைக்கிறோம். திரு ஆர் கார்த்திகேயன் எம்டிஎஸ் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். திரு ஆர் கார்த்திகேயன் அவர்கள் மேடைக்கு வருமாறு அழைக்கிறோம். திரு ஜி சுரேஷ்குமார் யூடிசி அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். திரு ஜி சுரேஷ்குமார் யூடிசி அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். திரு ஏ கார்த்திகேயன் எம்டிஎஸ் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். திரு ஏ கார்த்திகேயன் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். Moving up to the next section, in order to keep up the competitive spirit among the students so they may work harder every year, the institute management had decided to felicitate the best student from each year during the foundation day to encourage the students, not just at the end of their UG studies but end of each academic year, to strive for excellence. This award consists of a shield and a certificate. இளங்கலை மாணவர்களுக்கான விருது. நமது கல்லூரியில் ஒவ்வொரு ஆண்டும் பல பாடங்களில் சிறந்து விளங்கும் மாணவர்களுக்கு அவர்களின் பட்டமளிப்பு விழாவில் விருது வழங்கப்படுகின்றன. ஆனால் ஒவ்வொரு ஆண்டிலும் முதலாவதாக வரும் மாணவர்களுக்கு மற்றும் அனைத்து ஆண்டுகளுக்கும் சேர்ந்து முதன்மை மாணவராக வரும் மாணவருக்கு ஒவ்வொரு ஆண்டும் நிறுவன நாள் விழாவில் விருதுகள் வழங்கப்படும். இதில் முதலாவதாக வரும் மாணவர்களுக்கு நினைவு பரிசு மற்றும் சான்றிதழ் வழங்கப்படுகிறது.
We have Maheshwaran S, who has backed the best student for the award of for first BVSC and AH with a GPA of 8.73.
முதலாம் ஆண்டிற்கான முதல் மாணவர் விருது திரு மகேஸ்வரன் எஸ் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம்.
Next, we have Ankita R. Pai, who has been awarded the best student for second BVSC and AH with a CGP of 8.96.
இரண்டாம் ஆண்டிற்கான முதல் மாணவர் செல்வி அங்கிதா பாய் அவர்களை அழைக்கிறோம்.
Next up is Charulata S, who has been awarded the best student for third BVSC and AH and has a GPA of 8.72.
மூன்றாம் ஆண்டில் முதல் மாணவராக வந்துள்ள செல்வி சாருலதா எஸ் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம்.
Next up is Ratna Kumar S, who has been awarded the best student for 4th BBSC NDA with an outstanding GPA of 9.16.
நான்காம் ஆண்டில் முதல் மாணவராக வந்துள்ள திரு ரத்னகுமார் அவர்களை நேற்று அழைக்கிறோம். ஆண்டுகளுக்கும் சேர்ந்து முதன்மை மாணவராக வந்துள்ள விருதையும் மேடையிலிருந்தே பெற்றுக் கொள்ளுமாறு வேண்டுகிறோம்.
Award for the student with the best overall academic performance with the highest GPA during first to fourth BBSC and AH for the 2018 batch of students. The award goes to Ratna Kumar S, who has secured a GPA of 8.64. Extracurricular activities instrumental in building self-esteem. It helps to exhibit a person's potential in the areas of interest, skill and talent. We now have the award for the meritorious student who has excelled in academics as well as in extracurricular sports and arts, cultural and literary activities. This award has been sponsored by Namdev Mahadev Gavas. This award consists of a shield and a certificate. This award goes to Avnish Chaturvedi of third year.
கல்லூரியின் நிர்வாகம் கல்வி மட்டுமல்லாமல் இதர போட்டிகள் விளையாட்டுகள் அனைத்திலும் சிறந்து விளங்கும் மாணவர்களுக்கு விருது வழங்கி ஊக்குவிக்கிறது. இந்த ஆண்டு இந்த விருதை பெறுபவர் திரு அவினி சத்துர்வேதி ஆவார்.
We now have the Chief Secretary Award for the best performer in the All India Indian Council of Agricultural Research PG Entrance Examination 2024. This award is from the 2018 to 2023 batch of graduates. The student will be awarded with a cash prize of Rs. 5000, a memento and a certificate. For this year, the recipient of this award is Dr. Patan Bandekan Sabira Khanam.
ஐசிஆர் தேர்வில் முதலாவதாக வரும் மாணவருக்கு தலைமைச் செயலாளர் விருது வழங்கப்படுகிறது. இதன்படி ஒவ்வொரு ஆண்டும் முதலாவதாக வரும் மாணவர்களுக்கு ரூபாய் 5000 ரொக்க பரிசு, நினைவு பரிசு மற்றும் சான்றிதழ் வழங்கப்படும். இந்த ஆண்டிற்கான இந்த விருதை பெறுபவர் டாக்டர் ஷபீரா கணம் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு வருமாறு அழைக்கிறேன்.
We have the Thirumathi Suguna Pushnam Memorial Award for the best academic performance among MBSC students for the batch of 2021 to 2023. This award has been sponsored by Dr. Vijay Lakshmi, Professor and Head, Department of Veterinary Medicine, River, and the award consists of a shield and a certificate. The recipient of this award is Dr. Chimti C, who secured a GPA of 9.22.
2021 ஆம் ஆண்டிற்கான திருமதி சுகுணா புஷ்ணம் மெமோரியல் அவார்ட் இவ்விருதினை பெற்றுக்கொள்ள டாக்டர் சிமித்தி அவர்களை அழைக்கிறோம்.
Last year, the River Management has introduced the best research paper awards under two categories, that is research article as well as review paper, for the students as well as for the faculty. The articles published in journals with a NAS rating of 6 and above are considered for this award. This initiative is taken mainly to encourage students and faculty to publish in peer-reviewed journals and to recognize excellence in original research, innovative thinking, and the quality and impact of published work. This award consists of a shield and a certificate.
கல்லூரி நிர்வாகம் ஆராய்ச்சியை மேம்படுத்துவதற்காகவும் ஊக்குவிப்பதற்காகவும் பல விருதுகளை வழங்க உள்ளது. இதில் இளங்கலை மாணவர்கள், முதுகலை மாணவர்கள் மற்றும் பேராசிரியர்களுக்கு சிறந்த ஆராய்ச்சி கட்டுரை மற்றும் ஆய்வு கட்டுரைக்கான விருது வழங்கப்பட உள்ளது.
The best review article publication by the MBSC student in 2024 goes to Dr. E. Binuni Revis for the article Application of Artificial Intelligence for Heat Stress Management in Ruminant Livestock, published in Sensor with a NAS rating of 9.9 and an impact factor of 3.4. The co-authors of this article are Veerasami Sedian, Mulaka Parambil, Viludhya Silpa,
Rajendran Kalai Nyayal, Duraisami, Thirunavakarasu, Chinnasami Devaraj, Nikhil Kumar Tej, Nainan Jacob, Patran Bushahu, Nicola Lasitra and Frank Rowland Ganesha.
Yeah. The award for the best research article publication by the MBSC student of 2024 goes for the article titled Whole Genome Sequence Analysis of Canine Parvovirus that reveals replacement with novel CPV2C strains through India, which is published in the Archives of Virology with a NAS rating of 8.7 and impact factor of 2.7. We would like to call upon his mentor, Dr. Vivek Srinivas, to receive this award on his behalf.
சிறந்த ஆராய்ச்சி கட்டுரைக்கான விருதை பெறுபவர் டாக்டர் கே ஹரீஷ்.
By the faculty in 2024 goes to Dr. V.M. Vivek Srinivas for the article Molecular Detection of Cataract Species Isolated from Bovine Clinical Mastitis in India, which was published in the Veterinary Research Forum with a NAS rating of 7.0 and impact factor of 1.0. The co-authors are Niveda Devanathan, Jayalakshmi Vasu, Shashank Shabala and Hirak Kumar Mukhopadhyay.
பேராசிரியர்களுக்கான சிறந்த ஆராய்ச்சி கட்டுரைக்கான விருதை பெறுபவர் உதவி பேராசிரியர் டாக்டர் வி எம் விவேக் ஸ்ரீனிவாஸ் ஆவார்.
நெக்ஸ்ட் அப் இஸ் பெஸ்ட்
guest of honor for giving us his valuable time and for gracing us with his presence. Thank you, sir. Your speech was truly remarkable and I'm sure we all enjoyed being in your presence. Thank you, sir.
இவ்விழாவிற்கு வருகை தந்து இந்த விழாவை சிறப்பித்த நமது கௌரவ விருந்தினர் அவர்களுக்கு நன்றியை தெரிவித்துக் கொள்கிறோம்.
Technology Award, River. River is committed to the development of farmers-friendly technology to improve yield, efficiency and profit. The application of scientific knowledge for practical purposes for development of farming community plays a significant role in improving the production as well as welfare of both farm and pet animals. In order to encourage the team in developing such economically and farmer-friendly technologies, a research institute must develop low and cost-effective technology, and dissemination of it in the ultimate is the ultimate target of farmers who could apply that and improve their own production performance. This award consists of a shield and certificate. This year, team headed by Dr. Ellen Chajian has been awarded this award for the development of River Yes mineral mixture for small ruminants of Puducherry. The team members are Dr. D. Uma Maheshwari, Dr. George Dominic, and Dr. V. Chajian.
நிர்வாகம் ஏழை எளிய மக்களுக்கு பயன்படும் வகையில் சிறந்த தொழில்நுட்பத்தை வழங்க முயற்சி எடுத்துள்ளது. இந்த ஆண்டில் சிறந்த தொழில்நுட்பத்திற்கான விருதை பெற்றுக்கொள்ள பேராசிரியர் டாக்டர் என் இளஞ்செழியன் அவர்களை அழைக்கிறோம்.
Now move on to the next series of awards for the evening. Best Department Award. The departments are the heart and soul of our institute. In order to promote such department to gear up and conduct a lot of activities to improve the overall performance of the institute, an award for the best department has been introduced. This award is bestowed upon the department that has excelled on a whole in terms of activities as well as hard work. This award consists of a shield and a certificate. The best department award this year goes to the Department of Veterinary Public Health and Epidemiology. We request the head of the department, Dr. V. Banu Rekha ma'am, to kindly come over to the stage and receive the award.
கல்லூரியில் சிறந்த துறைக்கான விருது. இவ்விருதினை பெற்றுக்கொள்ள கால்நடை பொது சுகாதாரம் மற்றும் நோய் நிகழ்வியல் துறை அத்துறையின் தலைவர் பேராசிரியர் டாக்டர் வி. பானுரேகா அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். Members of the department to be on the stage. I request all the members of the department to be on stage.
Among the faculty members, the institute management has decided to award the best teacher for each year. The award is bestowed on those faculty who have made major contributions in the academic field via their teaching, and it is typically seen as a mark of acknowledgement and respect. The beauty of this award is that the students from each year have chosen the respective teachers, wherein the students were asked to evaluate each teacher with a set of 20 questions with complete anonymity. The average of each class has been taken into consideration for this award. The award consists of a shield and a certificate.
சிறந்த ஆசிரியர்களுக்கான விருது. கல்லூரி நிர்வாகம் சிறந்த ஆசிரியர்களுக்கான விருதை வழங்க உள்ளது. இந்த தேர்வினை செய்தவர்கள் கல்லூரி மாணவர்களே. ஒரு ஆண்டு நிறைவு செய்து அடுத்த ஆண்டிற்கு செல்லும் மாணவர் கடந்து வந்த ஆண்டின் ஆசிரியர்களில் சிறந்தவரை கேட்கப்பட்ட கேள்விகளின் மூலம் பதிலளித்து தேர்வு செய்தனர். அனைத்து மாணவர்களின் பதில்களை கொண்டு சிறந்த ஆசிரியர் தேர்வு செய்யப்பட்டுள்ளனர்.
The best teacher for first year BBSC and AH goes to Dr. Ragi Radhakrishnan, Assistant Professor, Department of Livestock Production Management.
முதலாம் ஆண்டுக்கான சிறந்த ஆசிரியர் விருதை பெறுபவர் டாக்டர் ராகி ராதாகிருஷ்ணன் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். இரண்டாம் ஆண்டிற்கான சிறந்த ஆசிரியருக்கான விருதை பெறுபவர் டாக்டர் எஸ். உமா அவர்களை அழைக்கிறோம். மூன்றாம் ஆண்டிற்கான சிறந்த ஆசிரியர் விருதை பெறுபவர் டாக்டர் ஆர். பூங்கலலி அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம்.
Teacher of fourth year BBSC and AH goes to Dr. N. Gurunathan, Assistant Professor, Department of Veterinary Surgery and Radiology.
நான்காம் ஆண்டிற்கான சிறந்த ஆசிரியர் விருதை பெறும் டாக்டர் என். குருநாதன் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம்.
சிறந்த
Next up is Best Institutional Building Activity Award. The River Management has decided that apart from regular academic activities, those faculty who have made a positive impact on the growth and development of the institution will be felicitated. Every year, such faculty will be recognized under this category and felicitated. This faculty, in addition to regular teaching, have had a sustainable positive impact on the growth and development of the institute. This award constitutes of a shield and a certificate.
பேராசிரியர்கள் அவர்களின் பயிற்றுவித்தல் பணிகளுக்கு இடையே நமது கல்லூரியின் நிர்வாகத்திற்கும் உறுதுணையாக பணிகள் செயல்படுத்துகின்றனர். அவர்களை கௌரவிக்கும் விதமாக இவ்விருது வழங்கப்பட உள்ளது.
First up is Dr. V.J. Ajay Kumar, Professor, Department of VPE and Deputy Registrar, Finance.
He had played a significant role in forcing the promotion process, purchase and administration processes.
Next up is Dr. S. Venkatesha Perumal, Professor in Head Department of BBC and Deputy Registrar Academics.
He has played a significant role in forcing the entire admission process of 100 UG students, handling all activities pertaining to Pondicherry University, leading the academic session during admission process, efficiently coordinates all activities of various awards and meritorious students.
Next up is Dr. J. Thanisalas, Professor and Head, CTR and CIF.
He has played a significant role in starting the PhD program at River, starting of diploma course, certification course, short-term course and training programs in CIF.
Next up is Dr. R. Ganeshan, Professor, Department of AGB and in charge PME cell.
As a PME cell in chat, he processes all files pertaining to requests received from faculty to serve as examiners, presenting lead talk, question paper setting and radio talks. Acting as a chief technical officer and providing valuable inputs to dean. Wraps all the communication for dean to ICR and other organizations.
Next up is our beloved Dr. P.K. Mandal sir, Professor and Head, Department of LPT.
He has done a tremendous job in coordinating all activities of PG admission, controlling all activities pertaining to first and second year PG, processing and fixing ORW seminars. Courses with Pondicherry University for PG students, TDC. He is the President of Indian Meat Science Association.
Next up is Dr. D. Uma Maheshwari, Professor and Head, Department of ANN.
Done a tremendous job as the Chief Superintendent of for smoothly conducting all examinations, both UG and PG, fixing up of dates for various examinations and pursuing with university. Consolidated marks and PDC of PG students.
Next up is Dr. A. Abhirami, Professor, Department of BMD and Internship Coordinator.
Very efficiently handling the internship program by coordinating various activities such as rotating the students in various instances and departments.
Next up is Dr. H.K. Mukhopadhyay, Professor in Head, VMC.
Chairman for River Students Disciplinary Committee, Organizing Secretary in conducting the ISS GPU Conference. Academic
Bhanu Rekha, Professor and Head VP.
Establishing CBA-sponsored rabies diagnostic lab of river coordinates all activities of ICC cell. Played a significant role in purchasing animal models to CBA animal health.
Next up is Dr. S. Kantaraj, Professor and Head Department of Veterinary Gynecology and Warden of the Hospital.
As a chief warden, handling all activities of both boys and girls hospital, creating basic instructions in boys hospital, supervision of hospital facilities during odd hours, maintenance of discipline in both the hospitals.
Next up is Dr. K. Rajalakshmi, Assistant Professor, Department of VAN.
As an Assistant Warden, that does a tremendous job in allocating quarters for all girls students, creating basic infrastructure in ladies' hostel, addressing all issues of girls students in ladies' hostel.
Is Dr. V.M. Vivek Srinivas, Assistant Professor, Department of BMC.
Played an important role in all activities pertaining to launching of new website of river, regularly updates day-to-day activities of institute and website, handling all the purchase procedures through GEM portal.
B. Srinivasan, Librarian cum Campus Department Development Officer.
Done a tremendous job in completely beautifying our river campus. Built now, establishing fountain and flash flooding platform of river. This year, river management has also decided to award non-teaching staff who have performed exceptionally in each of their categories and to promote healthy competition and to promote their performance. This award consists of a shield and a certificate. The award goes to lab technician Mr. C. Ilangovan. Sir Ilangovan, our main medic, Alitiro. ஓட்டுநர் திரு வி துரைராஜ் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். திரு வி துரைராஜ் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். அழைக்கிறோம். கிராஃப்ட்ஸ்மேன் திரு கே சிவகுமார் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். டேட்டா என்ட்ரி ஆபரேட்டர் திரு எம் ரவிச்சந்திரன் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். திரு எம் ரவிச்சந்திரன் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். கன்வென்ஷன் கிளர்க் திரு சுரேஷ்குமார் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். திரு ஜி சுரேஷ்குமார் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். லோவர் டிவிஷன் கிளர்க் மிஸ்டர் சி கணேசன் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம்.
Get the men with the black stripes here. Let's see it's like everyone right here. Bring it up, sipping on beer. Yeah, clap for me man right here. Get the men with the black stripes here. Bring it swagger down right here.
Lower division set. திரு சி கணேசன் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். திரு சி கணேசன் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். திரு வி ஆண்டவர் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். ராஜசேகர் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். திரு ராஜசேகர் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். திரு ஜி நேருதரன் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். திரு ஜி நேருதரன் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். மல்டிடாஸ்கிங் ஸ்டாஃப் ஜெனரல் திரு வி ஆண்டோயின் அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். மல்டிடாஸ்கிங் ஸ்டாஃப் ஜெனரல் திரு வி ஆண்டோனி அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். திரு ஆண்டோனி அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். மல்டிடாஸ்கிங் ஸ்டாஃப் ஹவுஸ் கீப்பிங் திரு இ வேலு அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். திரு இ வேலு அவர்களை மேடைக்கு அழைக்கிறோம். We will now award the students that have been selected slash represented Pondicherry University for the South Zone Inter-University Tournament for the year 2023-24 to show a token of our appreciation. We call upon Mr. Anson J. Bernard of 3rd BVSC NDH. He has been selected and represented for basketball Pondicherry University. Miss Pramila of 2nd BVSC and AH. She has been selected and represented for Kabaddi, Pondicherry University team, held at Alagappa University, Karaikudi. Next up is Miss Kuntamil of 1st BVSC and AH. She has been selected and represented at table tennis. Yeah.
is Ms. Kuntamil of 1st BBSC and AH for representing in table tennis. Next is Mr. Somesh of 1st BBSC and AH. Next is Ms. R. Shalini of 3rd BBSC and AH. Next is Ms. Prasanna Lakshmi of 3rd BBSC and AH. Next is Ms. Varsha Sridharan of 3rd BBSC and AH.
ప్రతి పుష్పం పువ్వున్నయామం మారిడం రాసకేళి తడాగం
ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్
సుఖ
పోర్టబుల్ టెన్నిస్. నెక్స్ట్ ఇస్ మిస్టర్ షోమేష్ ఆఫ్ ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్ ఫర్ రిప్రజెంటెడ్ ఫర్ టేబుల్ టెన్నిస్. మిస్టర్ షోమేష్ ఆఫ్ ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్. నెక్స్ట్ ఇస్ మిస్ షాలిని ఫర్ రిప్రజెంటెడ్ ఇన్ టేబుల్ టెన్నిస్. Next is Prasanna Lakshmi, who represented for basketball. Next is Varsha Sridharan, who represented for basketball. In the inter-college event that happened, our team was runner-up. I would request the team of table tennis to receive the awards. Next up, we will announce the inter-class competition for games. Goes to 1st BBHC and AH for the year 2023-24 with the overall point of 260. This is sponsored by our former dean, Dr. B. Ramesh Kumar. Inter-class competition for athletic meet goes to 3rd BBSC and AH for the year 2023-24 with the overall points of 330.
Been working tirelessly day and night to make all the events of this past week possible. And in order to recognize their efforts, the Dean would like to felicitate the Student Council. We first have our speaker, Ms. Arya Nambiar. Let's hear a huge round of applause for Arya. This award consists of a certificate and a shield. We have our Cultural Secretary, Mr. A. Dhanush. Our General Secretary, sorry. Next is the Deputy Speaker, Mr. Kamlesh B. Up Next is the Joint Secretary, Mr. Avnish Chaturvedi. Next, we have the Cultural Secretary, Ms. Harini P. We now have our Sports Secretary, Mr. Santosh.
Bloody sweet.
Joint Cultural Secretary, First Year, Maheshwaran. Joint Cultural Secretary of Second Year, Mr. Gautam, who is currently not present here. The Joint Sports Secretary, Mr. Anson. Next is the Treasurer, Mr. Varun. And finally, we have the Magazine Editor, Mr. Shiva Subramanian.
Now, felicitation of sponsors. நன்கொடையாளர்களுக்கான நினைவு பரிசு.
First we have Pet City, Pondicherry and Tamil Nadu. We request the representative to kindly come up on stage. Pet City. Next we have Capital Pharma, Coimbatore. We request the representative to kindly come on stage. New Delhi. I request the representative to come on stage. Up next is our sponsor, Cilantro, Nigeria. I request the representative to come on stage. A huge round of applause.
Second,
Ambir Medicals, Pondicherry. Ambir Medicals, Pondicherry. Next is Ponle, Puducherry. Requesting the representatives to be on stage. Ambir Medicals, Pondicherry. Ponle, Pondicherry. Ganesh Medicals, Cuddalore. Microbiology and Biotechnology YouTube channel. We have Bank of Baroda, Pondicherry. Bank of Baroda, Pondicherry. Next, We Care Pet Clinic, Pondicherry. We Care Pet Clinic, Pondicherry. Next, Fearless and Candace, Pondicherry. We Care Pet Clinic, Pondicherry. Fearless and Candace, Pondicherry. Refsin Biosciences Private Limited, Pondicherry. Refsin Biosciences. Next, Vets for Pets, Pondicherry. Vets for Pets, Pondicherry. Refsin Biosciences. Next is SLIMS, Sri Lakshmi Narayana Institute of Medical Sciences, Pondicherry. Next, Anamia Catering Services, Pondicherry. Classic Bakery, Kurumapet, Pondicherry. Next, Horizon Net Cafe, Kurumapet, Pondicherry. Namdev Gawas, Goa. Requesting any representative to come on stage. Requesting Omkar Gawas to kindly come on stage.
Next up is DJ Tyagu. Without his contribution, this function would not have been possible. A great thanks to that took place on day 4 of Riveria celebrations. First up is Tug of War Faculty, which was won by our Dean's team led by Dr. Avinash Lakhawar and Dr. Ponuvel sir. A I request all the members of that tug of war to come on stage. Events, I request only four members to come up on stage. Only four members, please. First tug of war men. First prize goes to third BBSC and AH. Tug of war women, first prize goes to 4th BBSC and AH. Goes to the PGs. Tug of war women, second prize goes to the PGs. Next up is solo song, regional and western. First prize goes to Alina Shazi from 1st BBSC and AH. Second prize goes to Vasant Nathan from PG. Third prize goes to Subiksha Selvi SK, first year.
Next we have the prizes for duet song. The first prize goes to Alina Shaji and Veda K of first year. The second prize goes to Dr. Vasant and Dr. G. Ilavarasi from PG.
Bachi, open the button!
First prize for duet song. Second prize goes to the PGs, Dr. Vasant and Dr. Ilavarasi. Also goes to the PGs, Dr. Binuni Rebez and Dr. Rayappa Sara, Mahimandali. Third prize for duet song goes to the PGs. Up next, we have the prizes for instrumental solo. The first prize goes to Sai Siddhartha V of first year BBSC and AH. The second prize goes to Shanmati MR Shiva Bharati of fourth year BBSC and AH. Devi Sanjay
Sanjesh Kumar of 4th year BBSC and AH. Up next, we have the prizes for group song. The first prize goes to the 4th years.
Group song, second prize goes to 1st BBSC and AH. Second prize goes to 1st BBSC and AH. Is synchro dance. The first prize goes to 4th years Manzima and Shanmadi. The second prize also goes to the 4th years Eco Overstree and Gauri Vinod. Next up is recreational dance. Recreational dance, first prize goes to 4th years.
I will request Rivers Mahesh Babu to come on stage. And Sri Leela also.
Next, the second prize goes to 2nd years. Second prize goes to the 2nd years. The third prize goes to the 3rd years. Prize goes to the 3rd years. Give a big round of applause for the winners, please. Show some energy.
Variety performances. The first prize goes to the 4th years. The first prize goes to the 4th years. We now have the prizes for fancy dress. The first prize is shared by Manjima Manoj Kumar of 4th year and Kupanati Prasanna Lakshmi of 3rd year. Diana Priyadarshini of PG. Third prize for fancy dress goes to Diana Priyadarshini of PG.
Next up is Fashion Shows Award. The crowd's favorite goes to Dr. Vineet PG. The Best Fashion Designer Award goes to Shivani from 4th year. Best Fashion Designer Award goes to Shivani S from 4th year. Best Costume Designer goes to Anikesh Ranjan, also from 4th year. Next is Mr. Catitude. The award goes to Bhardwaj P, intern. Miss Catitude award goes to Shanmati from 4th year. The next award is Fashion Innovator. It goes to Janani from 3rd year. Give a big round of applause for the winners. Next is the Mr. River Award. It goes to Kiridharan E from 3rd year. Next is Miss River Award. It goes to Alina Shazi from 1st year. Miss River goes to Alina Shazi from 1st year. Next up is Dynamic Duo Award, which goes to Manzima and Shanmadi from 4th year. Events. The first one is Reel Making. The first prize goes to second years, Pavindan, Karishma and Prithvi. The second prize goes to the fourth years, Dhanush, Rahul and Govind Vasan. The second prize goes to the fourth years, Dhanush, Rahul and Govind Vasan. The third prize goes to second BVSC and AH, Jagat, Robin, Vignesh. Next is Scene Recreation Award. The first prize goes to the PGs, Vasant Nathan, Mohammed Taufik, Dina Priyadarshini and Ilavasi. The second prize for Scene Recreation goes to Shalini R from 3rd year.
The first prize goes to Someswaru Lakshmi Devi from 4th year BVSC and AH. The second prize goes to DP India, intern. Next, we have the prize for meme recreation. The first prize goes to Sanjesh Kumar of 4th year BVSC and AH. Next, we have the prize for the best performer in male. Any guesses? Best performer overall for the culturals. It goes to Satyam of third year. Next, we have the best overall performer female. Any guesses for female? Yes, Sharmati of fourth year.
Next is overall champion for this cultural events. Any guesses? Second years, make some noise. It goes to fourth years. The trophy is sponsored by our dean. Maintain their streak continuously for 3 years. They have been winning this award, and this is their last year, not anymore. As we come to the end of our prize distribution ceremony, I would like to call upon the General Secretary of the Student Council, Mr. A. Dhanush, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Now we request Dr. Raja from 1994 batch to felicitate our dean, and he got recently retired. Let us give a huge round of applause for Dr. Now I request the representative of the Capital Pharma for the felicitation. The General Secretary of the Student Council, and I'm honored to deliver this vote of thanks. First and foremost, I would like to extend my sincere gratitude to our chief guest, our Honorable Dean, Dr. V. Selian. Thank you for gracing this event with your presence, for being a guiding light for all of us. A heartfelt thank you to our esteemed guest of honor, Dr. Arul Anand. Your presence was truly elevated in celebrations in marking this milestone. To our Associate Patron, Dr. Avinash Lakavar, and our Assistant Associate Patron, Dr. Bharati Raja sir. I seriously don't have any words to describe the amount of contribution you have done to make this event a grand success. Thank you so much, sir. To our respected faculty members, we owe a great deal of appreciation. Your dedication and tireless efforts in shaping our education and character are invaluable. Thank you, everyone. A special request to Dr. Kantraj sir, Dr. Selvi, Dr. Rajalakshmi ma'am, Dr. Mandal sir, Dr. Vivek sir, and Dr. Gurunathan sir, thank you for believing in us. To our esteemed alumni, a special thank you for being here today. Your journey from this institution to the success you have achieved serves as an inspiration for all of us. We are proud to be the part of the legacy that you helped build, and your continued support is deeply appreciated. To our generous sponsors, your contribution have allowed us to transform this event into something special. With limited time of our preparation, your support has been vital in making this day a truly spectacular one. To our dear parents, thank you for your presence today and for your constant encouragement and belief in us. To my fellow students, thank you for your enthusiastic participation and making today's celebration a reflection of the vibrant spirit that defines our college. To all the non-teaching staff, thank you everyone. To my fellow council members, actually they are my family, what an incredible team they are. In just a few short weeks, we managed to create something unforgettable. Thank you for everyone for your hard work, creativity and dedication. It has been an honor to lead alongside such a talented and driven individuals. I really need a huge round of applause for this whole student council body. I would like to extend my deepest appreciation to the organizing committee, the volunteers, especially the second and the third year boys, and everyone who worked behind the scenes to make today's event a resounding success. Your hard work, dedication, and attention to the detail have ensured that this day will be remembered for years to come. Finally, I would like to take a moment to thank my parents. Mom and Dad, I hope you will be proud of me as I stand here today. As we conclude today's celebration, let us take with us the pride of being part of this distinguished institution and one of that has flourished over the past 30 years and will continue to inspire excellence in the years ahead. Thank you all once again for being a part of this milestone event. Have a wonderful day.
Thank you, Dhanush. We will now request everyone to stand for the national anthem.
Desiya Geetham, Anaivarayum Elumaru Kettukolgirom.
Time.